Anyway, Tom Sowell testified at a congressional hearing, and guess who he was questioned by? He was questioned by then-Senator Joe Biden. And Sowell was explaining to Congress, not only are race-based preferences unfair in the sense that somebody is getting an advantage over somebody else who had nothing to do with why the person who's getting the advantage supposedly is in need of the advantage. Forget about the morality side of this. There's also a practical side. And what Tom Sowell said is that by admitting people with lower credentials, they're more likely to drop out. And when they drop out, they don't go to a lesser competitive school. They just drop out and therefore become far less economically viable than they would have been had they gone to a less competitive school. So it hurts the very people that affirmative action or race-based preferences are designed to help. So Tom Sowell explained all of that to Joe Biden, and Sowell explained to them that the blacks that get involved, they get admitted into MIT, they are at the bottom of those that they compete with at MIT, but at the top of those who don't go to MIT. So these blacks who got into MIT, said Tom Sowell, would have done fine had they gone to a less competitive school, but because they got into MIT because of race-based preferences, they dropped out, become less economically viable, hurts them, hurts the country, hurts everybody. This is what Tom Sowell was trying to explain to Joe Biden, who, by the way, according to one of my sources, did not just graduate at the bottom half of his class when he told a person at one of these town hall meetings he graduated the top half. Turns out he graduated not just at the bottom half, he graduated last in his class at Syracuse University, according to one of my sources. So watch this exchange between Tom Sowell and Joe Biden as Sowell is trying to explain to Biden it doesn't make any sense to admit people with lesser credentials because they're not going to do well, they're going to drop out.
I think one of the great handicaps that blacks and other minorities face across the country is that they are systematically mismatched with universities in the admissions process. That is, if Harvard feels that it must have X percent of blacks, and if the pool is such that they can't get X percent of blacks at the same level as the rest of the Harvard students, they're going to take those blacks who would have succeeded in some state university and bring them to Harvard, where many of them will fail. Or MIT is a better example, that the average black student at MIT is in the bottom 10% of MIT students in math, but he is in the top 90% of all American students in math because MIT students are so phenomenal in mathematics. Something like one-fourth of all the black students going to MIT do not graduate. You're talking about a pool of people who score at the 90th percentile in math whom you are artificially turning into failures by mismatching them with the school. The problem is not whether you believe that school desegregation should have ended. I believe it should have ended long before. Mm-hmm. George Bork believes it should have ended long before. What he and what I have objected to are the principles used in that decision, because those principles take on a life of their own, and they come back to haunt you in other areas. Obviously, this old phrase, the hard cases make bad law, derived from that fact. You dream up a principle to reach this result, and then the principle has a life of its own. Then this is what bothers me. People are talking about how judges should be sensitive to this particular group or that particular group. And if that means anything, if it means he's applying the law differently, that's precisely how blacks were held down for generations in the South.
So
by
literacy
applying the law differently.
So literacy tests, as long as they were equally applied, are all right.
Sure.
So I thought you thought. I gather from your comments about MIT and Harvard that you don't think there's enough blacks out there who are qualified to fill the number of vacancies allotted for them in those schools.
Now, did you hear that? I gather from your question about statement about MIT and Harvard, you feel there aren't enough blacks to fit the number of seats allotted for them. Number of seats allotted for them? What the hell are you talking about? And Joe Biden doesn't think there's any problem with that. Because diversity means you need to have a certain number of blacks, certain number of Hispanics, certain number of Asians. And by the way, Asians used to be minority, but they're not minority when it comes to admissions in the colleges and universities, because studies show that the group that gets screwed because of these race-based preferences are Asians.
That right? Is that what you're
saying? Well, the word qualifies really is misleading.
I got it. So, but my point is, you believe there are not enough black women and men out there that are the same as white women and men to be able to go through Harvard and MIT. Yeah, what you're saying?
My question, what I think, is a factual matter.
So factually, saying factually there are not enough.
Factually, this study's already been done by Clickguard at Harvard, and the figures are all there. Anyone can look them up.
What Tom Sowell is explaining to Joe Biden is, if you look at the criteria for admissions into schools like Harvard, very few blacks, for whatever reasons, are not meeting those standards. And if you admit them anyway, they're more likely to drop out. Joe Biden was dumbfounded by that. Now, what I'm dumbfounded by is Joe Biden went to a college of law school called University of Syracuse. It's not Harvard. He graduated last in his class. He became a senator from Delaware, and then became vice president of the United States. Apparently, you can succeed even if you are black and don't end up going into Harvard. Apparently.